Education reform was one of the three major challenges that Governor Christie highlighted in the State of the State address. Joining us now to talk about fundamental education reform in New Jersey are Dr. Anthony Scarillo, Chairman of the Department of Education and Director of Graduate Education at St. Peter's College, and Dr. Joan Moriarty, Assistant Professor of Education at Caldwell College. Thank you both for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you here. Let me ask you this. As I said, the governor has made education reform one of his key challenges, action items, as he calls it. And the two big things he wants to do is end teacher tenure and implement merit pay for individual teachers.
Not schools,
but individual teachers.
Right.
Tony, let me start with you. Is that the right way to go?
I think those are two of the components, I think, of any kind of education reform in New Jersey. I don't think that you can focus just on those two things. I'm not so sure that...
Yeah, he has other items, but those are the big two that he keeps talking about.
Let's take one at a time.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do the tenure issue.
On the tenure issue, the question is whether or not there's really a problem with the system of tenuring teachers now, I think, or is the problem that we have not put into place the appropriate evaluation procedures for teachers. The governor and the governor before him were adamant about opening up the inroads for teachers to come from various areas. So we now have teachers who do change of careers. We now have teachers who come the alternate route. Have we modified the supervision and the evaluation process so that we're appropriately training those teachers that they move forward?
Let's put things in perspective. After 3 years, after this extensive evaluation, if a teacher gets tenure, okay. And by the way, the New Jersey Education Association, and folks who know this show know that they're one of the underwriters, but it doesn't change this question. The NJEA also acknowledges that it takes too long and that it's too expensive to get rid of a quote-unquote bad teacher. They argue, instead of going through the judicial process, bring in a third party, an arbitrator. Governor says 5-year renewable contracts. Which one makes more sense?
Well, the instructional leaders, the principals today, have a whole new role in the education, not just in hiring teachers and retaining them for tenure. And having a principals roundtable, most of our principals feel that tenure could protect teachers in a political climate that could be rash.
I mean, if someone had it in for a certain teacher,
tenure could protect that teacher.
It eliminates their freedom to teach as they see fit.
Absolutely, but it should never protect a teacher that isn't performing.
Has it?
If it could have, yes, I think it has. If instructional leaders at the time, if it's difficult to get a teacher out of the program, it has happened. I think all of us know somewhere along the line a teacher that has been ineffective, whether your child had that teacher or as a former principal.
So on balance, which is the biggest threat to education, to good education in New Jersey? Is it a tenure system that keeps a lot of bad teachers or some bad teachers in the system? Or a lack of tenure that makes it difficult or makes it more problematic for teachers to be free in an education process and that opens up the possibility of patronage? Which is more of a threat?
Take a shot.
I think the renewable contract is a bigger detriment. I think that the tenure process,
like the renewable contract.
I'm not comfortable with the renewable contract
yet. Let's be specific. Time is tight here. What's wrong with the 5-year renewable contract?
I think it exposes good teachers to being released from a district because of political reasons.
Really?
I would prefer to look at the tenure dismissal process and look at the criteria for the dismissal. I disagree with the NJEA. You're not going to go to a third party. That's just going to bring it to arbitration. We know what the governor said about arbitration, about arbitrators, right. how they're.
So how do you fix it? Without getting rid of it?
I would go for the statutory change on the criteria for tenure removal. The criteria. There are five criteria. There
are
five major.
Quickly.
Conduct unbecoming, incapacity, inefficiency, and absenteeism.
And how would it change?
Well, if we take the same model that we use for inefficiency, which requires a corrective action plan, which requires a period of time of review before you get to the tenure proceedings, if you look at the tenure dismissals for inefficiency, significantly more successful, better than 90% successful, quicker, less expensive than going the other route.
I'm going to give John a chance. Do you agree?
I agree. I agree with what Tony is saying, that the dismissal, what we feel is so expensive, is to
make it too easy to dismiss teachers is a big problem, you're saying, essentially.
Well, under what the reform is saying, that there's a perception that tenure protects ineffective teachers and it's too costly. That if there was a common thread, as Tony alluded to before, of teacher evaluations, that teachers were compared, unilaterally would be better that they had the same evaluation system.
Do you like the 5-year renewable contract?
I don't.
You don't? Neither one of you do. Okay,
so you got, what about merit pay for individual teachers? Every other business, when somebody does well, they get rewarded for it.
I was wondering why you got a raise this year. Then.
I knew that was coming.
You walked right into it. Go ahead.
I think merit pay based on what? If it's merit pay based on number of students getting proficient on the NJS test, that is very difficult because we have art teachers, we have home ec teachers, we have shop teachers.
What is the criteria
for merit pay?
You know, that I keep hearing. I mean, the teachers union says that it creates competition among teachers and that's bad. Now, that doesn't make that much sense to me. But the other argument that there's not, you know, you can't really tell, how do you measure it? I don't know. When I was growing up, when I was a student, I think everybody knew who the good teachers were and who the bad teachers were. Is it that difficult to determine who deserves merit pay?
Well, you need to know what the criteria are.
Right.
You know, a child could really like some teachers who are absolutely great and wonderful and make that classroom environment, but are they teaching what the child should know at that level?
So you were in the principal's position.
I was.
So before we go back to Tony, do you argue that it's very difficult to create criteria that makes it fair to give merit pay to certain teachers?
Well, I think in essence we have somewhat of a merit pay in place right now. When you look at towns where the teachers are going up each year a step, is a merit pay for doing their job well to retain
them
another year.
That's not based on seniority?
Well, it's merit for doing a good job because you can withhold the increment.
So you don't think we need a separate merit pay system for individual teachers?
I am wavering with the idea of the collaboration, I mean, the cooperation. I would rather have us research-based proven for better children achievement, student achievement in the school place with more collaboration and developing professional learning communities.
Tony, your shot. Got 30 seconds.
I think merit pay is a good thing. I think, but more important than the merit pay piece is the psychology of the people who come into teaching. They're just not prepared to be in a merit pay situation. If you study the psychology of a teacher, they're a much more conservative group of people. They're in there for the low risk of the
not
job.
Not conservative from an ideological
no,
or political
conservative
point
in terms of,
view.
Of the time. They're not risk takers. I'm sorry.
Okay,
they're
so
not risk takers.
They're not entrepreneurial enough
to
merit pay?
No, if you read the merit pay studies, they will tell you that teachers will give up the merit pay piece not to have it and to make just their base
really?
Salary. The most recent study has just come out months ago said that exact thing.
Well, Tony, I want to thank you, Jonah. Thank you. I know this is very complex stuff, and we'll have representatives from the NJEA talking about this and other issues.
And other issues, yeah, because we missed a lot of them. Thank you so
thanks
much.
Thanks, Jonah. Thanks, Tony.